Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today, I'm about to save you hundreds of dollars with 12 amazing free programs that will completely transform your computing experience, whether you're on Windows, Mac, or Linux. Ever feel like you're missing out on powerful software because of those hefty price tags? Well, get ready because I'm about to show you alternatives that are not just free, but in some cases, even better than their paid counterparts. Before we dive in, if you're new here and love discovering awesome software and tech tips, hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you never miss our newest videos here on Software Hope. Let's jump straight into these fantastic free programs that cover everything from privacy protection to media players and system optimization tools. First up is the Tor browser. While browsers like Brave do a good job with privacy, Tor takes it several steps further to give you maximum security while browsing. Using a network of more than 6,000 relays, this open source browser encrypts your web traffic to keep you anonymous online. Yes, browsing will be a bit slower, but that's the trade-off for serious privacy protection. Tor blocks third-party trackers, removes cookies and browsing history, and even lets you access the dark web, sites not indexed by mainstream search engines. When you first open Tor, you'll see a connection screen. Just check Always Connect Automatically to bypass this in the future. Click Connect, and you're browsing anonymously. Tor browser works on Windows, macOS, Linux, and there's even a mobile app for Android users. Moving on to something completely different, Sumatra PDF is a free and open source document viewer supporting multiple formats, including PDF, EPUB, and CHM. What makes it special? It's incredibly lightweight and fast, a fantastic alternative to Adobe Reader with zero clutter. The first thing I do when buying a new appliance or vehicle is download the owner's manual, and Sumatra makes viewing these files a breeze, especially PDFs with bookmarks. Sumatra is Windows only, but there are portable versions available, meaning you can run it from a USB drive without installation. Next up is SM Player. Perfect for those looking for an alternative to VLC. If you've used VLC, you either love it or think it's garbage. There's rarely a middle ground. SM Player should be less divisive because it simply works with less bloat. It supports most file formats and codecs, so it'll play virtually anything. You can change playback speed, use subtitles, and even customize the look with different skins. The interface is intuitive, but the most useful feature is auto bookmarking. If you're watching a movie and close the player before finishing, it remembers exactly where you left off. SM Player is available for Windows, Linux, and now macOS. Just a heads up, since it's not digitally signed, common with open source programs, your OS might show a security warning. The latest release from May 2024 is perfectly safe, so just ignore the warning. Another great media player for Windows users is Media Player Classic Black Edition, a fork of the original MPC. It's free, open source, light on system resources, and fantastic for those having issues with other media players. All controls are conveniently located at the bottom, making it super easy to use. This one's quick. We've previously recommended QBitTorrent, but many of you suggested Transmission as an alternative. After testing, we have to agree, it's impressive. Transmission isn't a resource hog, and the upload and download process runs smoothly. The interface is more intuitive and polished than QBitTorrent, though honestly, both are excellent choices. Transmission works on Windows, macOS, and various Linux and Unix distributions. Next up is BleachBit, the absolute best open source cleaner for freeing up disk space and optimizing your system. While you could do most of this manually, why waste time when this program does it all for you? BleachBit is packed with features to help your computer run smoothly and maintain privacy. It deletes cookies, logs, temporary files, and clears cache and internet history. It also cleans dozens of programs, including Chrome, Firefox, Skype, VLC, and many others. Pro tip, always back up your system before running any cleaner. When you open BleachBit, you'll see two panes. Clicking any category on the left shows a description on the right of what happens if you select that item. Only check options you fully understand. If something might take a long time or delete stored passwords, you'll get a warning. For example, with Firefox, if you don't want to lose saved passwords, just click Cancel when prompted. When ready, select Preview in the upper left to see a report of files to be deleted and space to be recovered. Then click Clean to proceed. Depending on what you selected, this could take a while. BleachBit is available for Windows and Linux, with special editions for macOS and email servers. Blender is an incredible open-source graphics toolset used to create animated films, 3D models, visual effects, video games, and more. It includes 3D modeling, sculpting tools, rigging and skinning, plus a built-in video editor. I'll be honest, the user interface can be overwhelming at first, and Blender has the steepest learning curve of all programs in this video. Fortunately, their website offers excellent tutorials to help beginners get started. Blender works on Windows, macOS, and Linux. TreeSize Free is a graphical disk usage analyzer similar to Winderstat, but with a cleaner interface, making it easier to find what's taking up space on your drives. For best results, run it as administrator. Then select the drive you want to analyze by clicking the arrow next to Select Directory. For most of you, C will be your main system drive, with D often used for additional storage. After selecting your drive, wait for the scan to complete. The results show folders in order of space usage. Click the arrows beside each folder to explore subfolders. For a different view, go to the toolbar at the top, click View, and try the tree map chart option. You can expand this by dragging the left side. Works on Windows, macOS, and Linux. OBS Studio is a free, open-source screen recorder perfect for creating tutorials, recording gameplay, or streaming to platforms like Twitch and YouTube. There are no watermarks, no time limits, and you can set up unlimited scenes. Just be aware that computers with lower specs might experience some lag. The interface might look complex at first, and some people dislike the infinity effect when recording their screen. If that bothers you, just minimize OBS once recording starts. OBS Studio works on Windows, macOS, and Linux. CPU-Z is a Windows-only tool that provides detailed information about your computer's hardware. This system profiling and monitoring program detects your CPU, GPU, motherboard, chipset, RAM, and other components. The program has several tabs for different hardware categories: CPU, mainboard, memory, SPD, serial presence detect for additional memory info, and graphics. The bench tab lets you benchmark your CPU or run stress tests. This information is invaluable when upgrading components or deciding if an upgrade is necessary. CPU-Z comes in classic and custom versions. Most users should install the classic version, which now supports the latest and insanely expensive NVIDIA RTX 5000 series graphics cards. For our more niche picks, Scribus is a free, open-source alternative to Adobe InDesign. This publishing tool works with popular formats to create professional-quality newsletters, brochures, posters, and more. Scribus is available for Windows, macOS, and Linux. And finally, if you're a Windows user who thinks the default image viewer is terrible, ImageGlass is your savior. It's light on system resources and supports over 80 file formats. And there you have it, 12 amazing free programs that can transform your computing experience. All links to these fantastic tools are in the description below. If this video was useful, give it a thumbs up and share it with anyone who might benefit from these free alternatives. What free programs do you use that I didn't mention? Let everyone know in the comments below. And if you haven't already, subscribe and ring that bell so you don't miss our newest software videos and other tech content here on Software Hope. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.